Hey everyone, this is Owen with Motion Array, and in this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to export a GIF from After Effects without any third-party plugins. Well, kind of. You see, it's actually done with Media Encoder, but I'd advise you to go ahead and get used to this workflow because Adobe is moving more and more render options exclusively to Media Encoder. You can no longer render H.264 or WAV files straight from After Effects. You have to use Media Encoder. It might just be a matter of time before everything is done through Media Encoder. All right, let's get started. So here I am in After Effects, and I've got this composition with an animation that I'm ready to turn into a GIF. I've already trimmed my work area to just what I want to be rendered, just like I would normally. So I'll go to Composition, Add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. This launches Media Encoder, and it'll drop this composition into the queue. So you can see my composition in the render queue now. You can also add compositions to your queue by clicking this plus button up here, and then you can navigate to your project file. So I can choose this project file, and it'll open up my project panel, and then I can navigate to the exact composition. Just takes a while to load up. So there it is. I can just choose that composition and hit OK, and you see it adds it right there. All right, so under Format, you can see that mine's already on Animated GIF. If yours doesn't say that, and it probably won't, you just have to click this drop-down arrow and you can see Animated GIF right there. Mine's only set to that because it was the last thing I did. Under Preset, I'll click this blue type to bring up some options. Okay, so in the Export Settings, I'll click on this blue type by Output Name, and that'll let me choose what I want to call the GIF and where I want to save it. So I'll go ahead and navigate to where I want to put it, and then I'll change the name. Then the rest of the settings I'll leave the same, except I'll check use maximum render quality. Then I'll hit OK. And then all that's left to do is to start the render queue with this green little arrow up here in the right. As soon as it's done rendering, then you're done. So I will navigate over to that. And there's my final GIF. There's a few things I'd like to point out with regards to GIFs in Media Encoder. Since Premiere also uses Media Encoder, you can export GIFs from your Premiere sequences too. Another great thing about Media Encoder is that you can set your After Effects comps or Premiere sequences to render and then keep working instead of waiting for them to finish. Adobe has made some pretty cool features inside of Media Encoder, so I encourage you to give it a try. Well, that concludes this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. If you did and you'd like to see more tutorials, please go ahead and subscribe because we're making new ones all the time. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.